Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. A few weeks back, we announced the Black Slate had endorsed Gary Peters. Then now we've learned that Fannie Lou Hamer PAC has endorsed Hanson Clark for the 14th District. So there's only one more independent PAC that will serve as the tiebreaker in the war for the endorsements of independent PACs, and that is the Community Coalition. Ernest Johnson, head of the Community Coalition. What's happening, man?
All right, good to be here this morning.
All right, tiebreaker. What did the Community Coalition do? Who did you all endorse in the 14th District?
I'm at the printer right now, and I really tried to reach out to Hanson Clark, but he never returned the call. We did a no endorsement. I'm putting my troops over there in John Conyers' 13th district.
So no endorsement in the 14th district?
No endorsement on that. It's a principle thing. I understand why the Fannie Lou Hamer did Hanson Clark, because 1965 Voting Rights Act gave Michigan two black seats to be representative in Congress. And so the district's supposed to be redrawn to represent a majority of the minority, which would be, it should be a majority of black people, even in the redrawn district. And they say it's 58% African-Americans in the 14th and the 13th. But as you know, and we know, we don't vote as high as the suburban community vote.
And that is correct, but is Hanson Clark black?
Well, he's in the black caucus. So they accept him in the black caucus.
Okay.
And so it won't, they don't think they'll accept Peters in there.
All right, every year this comes up. Mm-hmm. Why does it cost so much to be on the slate? So let's say you guys endorse somebody, then it costs somebody $500,000, $1,500 to be on the slate. Why is there all that cost?
It shouldn't be that much. It should be just a minimum amount to be on the, to, for the service that's served. If I'm printing $4,000 worth of slates, I don't want to pay for it and have your picture on it, and my picture ain't on there, and I have pay people to pass them out, and they work all day, and then I feed them. Then since your picture on there, you should pay for your picture being on there. I mean, not pay, but you're just paying for a service. Really, what the slate should do, it should get somebody elected. And if a slate don't make a difference, then you shouldn't be on the slate. But if a person gonna work on a poll from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. and they're gonna get minimum wages and bologna sandwich, no, chicken sandwich or whatever, then the person that's running had to feed them.
Do people still believe in the validity of the Community Coalition slate? I mean, it was started by basically you and Don Barden to get it done.
Right.
All right.
Right.
And then, you know, Mr. Barden's gone and Ms. Marshall's gone.
I know, man. That's a big blow.
Is the faith still there?
Well, this is the first race I'm doing without them, but I think that people are going to still believe it. I'm going to tell you something else, that we ain't going to be doing this too much longer because, you know, it's a service to the community, but the lifespan of a community coalition is about two more years. We're going to get involved in the next mayor's race and the next county exec and governor's race. And then we're going to dedicate, you know, the memory to Don Barden. We're going to do some other stuff like we're doing the health fair.
Yes. Tell us about the health fair real quick.
We got a health fair that's going to be one of the biggest health fairs of the year. It's going to be August the 11th. That's a Saturday from 10 to 3. We're going to have free screening. We're going to have something for everybody. We're going to have pony rides for the kids. We're going to have face painting. We're going to do a special tribute in memorial of Don H. Barden. And we're going to do a presentation. I'm going to have some information to pass out. And we're going to have different rooms where you're going to have presentations.
Where is this going to be held?
It's going to be held at Greater Grace on 7 Mile.
Okay.
So we want all the community to mark that date on your calendar. That is August the 11th from 10 to 3. I need volunteers. The volunteer is going to get a beautiful T-shirt.
What do the volunteers call, Ernie?
The volunteers should call me, 313-808-0420, 313-808-0420, and you'll be serving the community, and you'll get a nice, beautiful T-shirt with Don Barden, Community Coalition on the back. It's going to be a collective item.
Okay. Ernie, thanks for coming down.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, I think only 50,000 people actually going to vote at the polls on Election Day.
You mean totally in
Not
Detroit?
Totally in Detroit is going to be about 81,000.
Oh, 81,000.
And you have about 50,000 only at the polls.
So oh, the absentee. You're talking about absentee. They said the absentee is up.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Maybe I'll be wrong.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.